Hello and welcome to our public meeting on the proposed rule for Washington State Register number 23-006-075 for disability designation and special use permits. Thank you so much for joining us today remotely. My name is Scott Bird and I'm the agency rules coordinator for the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife. Today's date is April 10th, 2023, and the time is now 1 p.m. This meeting is being recorded and the recording will be made available online on our rulemaking page shortly after the meeting has concluded. I'd also like to state for the record that Director Kelly Susswind is in attendance at today's hearing. This public hearing was noticed on the CR-102 rule proposal, which was filed on March 1st, 2023. We will have a presentation to brief you on the rule proposal, and then we will take public comment from attendees. When it is your turn to testify, please keep your comments to 3 minutes or less to allow enough time for everyone to speak. With that, let's jump straight into the presentation. We're pleased to introduce Catherine Waldrop, our Special Use Permits Program Specialist, who will be providing today's presentation, and Larry Delgado, our Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Manager. Catherine, Larry, go ahead.
Thank you, Scott. And thank you, Larry, for managing the PowerPoint slides. If you could move to the next one, please. We'll provide a brief outline of our presentation. So we'll have a program overview of the disability designation and special use permit program and the impetus for this rulemaking. There were a few title changes since the CR-102 was published on 3-1, which we will list on the variances slide. We'll cover the proposed amendments to the current rules, then the new rules the department has proposed. The chronology of the rulemaking process will be covered and we'll give a basic summary of comments we've received thus far from the public on this proposed rulemaking. At that point, we will take verbal public testimony for the department to consider. Next slide, please. The department strives to enhance opportunities for persons with disabilities to engage in fish, shellfish, and wildlife-related recreational activities. Disability designation, also known as disability status, is an accommodation to ensure a person with a permanent disability has reasonable access to the department's programs, services, activities, lands, and facilities. It is awarded to a person whose permanent disability is certified by a medical professional as meeting the eligibility requirements in WAC 220-200-160. Disability designation benefits include the right to designate another licensed individual to assist with or to actually perform the functions the person with the disability is unable to perform. It also affords the opportunity to apply for special disability hunts, tags, and raffles, participate in programs such as the ADA Road Access Entry Program, and utilize accessible hunting and fishing facilities. The Special Use Permit Program is another benefit for those awarded disability designation, allowing for specific equipment or program modifications and reasonable access permits. The Special Use Permits address permanent limitations, such as visual, mobility, or upper extremity impairments or developmental disabilities that commonly impact a person's ability to participate in hunting and fishing activities. Next slide, please. Each request for accessibility is considered and processed individually. However, there are three specific types that have been the most commonly requested: a crossbow, a scope device, and shooting from a vehicle, AKA the blue placard. Currently, there is a unique application with specific eligibility requirements for each of the three subs. The person must have disability designation already and submit the sub application fully completed by an appropriate medical professional. We'll go over those requirements soon. The table on this slide reflects the number of each of those subs that Department of Fish and Wildlife has awarded in recent years. Next slide, please. The department seeks to increase the participation and diversity of individuals interested in recreational hunting and fishing opportunities. The special use permit or SUP program is an additional accommodation providing equipment or program modifications and reasonable access permits, otherwise referred to as SUPs, for those who've been awarded a disability designation. The proposed rulemaking is intended in part to streamline and simplify the process of applying for disability designation and SUPs, and to reduce the current duplication of effort required. The changes are intended to further reduce barriers that may impede participation by persons with disabilities and streamline administrative processes, thereby increasing the efficiency of internal operations. The proposed rules provide appeal rights and also ensure that the application of standards for program modifications and accessibility permits are consistent and equitable by specifying the criteria for the most common SUPs. In accessibility permits, are consistent and equitable by specifying the criteria. I'm sorry, I apologize. In addition to the three already mentioned, crossbow, so scope, and shooting from a vehicle, we've included alternate casting gear in fly fishing seasons. The details are in the proposed new rules, specifically WACS 220-200-200 through 220-200-230. This package of new rules and amendments to current rules is available to view on our public rulemaking webpage at wdfw.wa.gov/about/regulations, where you can also find out more about the terms and conditions of SUPs, new definitions, and other rulemaking documents such as the CR 101, CR 102, etc. Next slide, please. This variant slide reflects any errors in the CR 102 or changes to it since publication on 3/1/23. And they consist only of rule titles. For WAC 220-200-190, the proposed title was listed on the CR 102 rather than the current rule title, which is disability designation. In WAC 220-200-210 and 220, the words special use permit dash eligibility dash terms and conditions were added to the end of each title shown in the CR 102. WAC 220-200-230, the proposed title in the CR 102 on page 1 was different than on page 2. The final proposed WAC title now reads, quote, alternate casting gear special use permit dash eligibility dash terms and conditions, end quote. Next slide, please, Larry. The proposed rule amendments are covering the rules as shown on your screen, and we'll go into the specifics of those proposed amendments to current rules, which does include WACS 220-200-160 through 220-200-190. And we are also proposing amendments to WAC 220-305-120. Next slide, please. The proposed amendment to WAC 220-200-160 provides clarity by addressing formatting errors. The paragraph labeled C in the current rule is more comprehensive than and is intended to include the paragraphs labeled A and B, lower and upper extremity disability, respectively. In the proposed rule, the paragraphs are rearranged so that original paragraphs A and B, lower and upper extremity disability, fall under original paragraph C, which encompasses both. Paragraphs are relabeled accordingly, such that original paragraph C is labeled A, and original paragraphs A and B are labeled I and double I. Likewise, for original paragraphs 2 and 3 of this WAC, the definitions of blind or visually impaired and developmental disability, they are intended to be sub-definitions of the term person with a disability in paragraph 1. Therefore, paragraphs 2 and 3 have been moved under paragraph 1 and relabeled as subparagraphs B and C. Also proposed under this WAC 220-200-160 are two separate new definitions for terms that are utilized in the proposed new rules. Specifically, quote, approved medical professional, end quote, and, quote, in good standing, end quote. The proposed rule amendment for WAC 220-200-170 codifies standard terms and conditions that apply to all subs, currently being listed on each permit or award letter. For WAC 220-200-180, the proposed amendment increases agency options for managing special use permits by adding the ability to modify and revoke those permits. It also requires the department to notify a person of the basis for a suspension, modification, or revocation of a special use permit. In addition to the existing appeal rights for a suspension, this rule proposal also establishes appeal rights and timeframes when a special use permit is modified, revoked, or denied. Next slide, please, Larry. The rule amendment proposed under WAC 220-200-190 allows the agency to suspend a person's disability designation and related benefits if the person submits fraudulent information when applying for their disability designation. The amendment requires the department to notify a person of the basis for a suspension or denial of a person's disability designation. This rule proposal also adds appeal rights when a person's disability designation is suspended and clarifies the timeframe for appealing a suspension or denial. The department proposes amending WAC 220-305-120 to update and clarify terminology related to casting gear to align with terms used in the proposed new rule WAC 220-200-230, which is alternate casting gear special use permit. Next slide, please. Director Suswin, do you have any questions or comments on the department's proposed rule amendments?
No, no questions for me. That's pretty clear.
Thank you. Moving on, we'll now brief on the proposed package of brand new rules for the SUP program. These consist of WACs 220-200-200 through 220-200-240. Larry, next slide, please. Thank you. For WAC 220-200-200, the new rule proposal allows use of a crossbow during archery or muzzleloader season by a person with a qualifying upper extremity or developmental disability, which permanently impairs the person's ability to hold and safely utilize a longbow, recurve bow, or compound bow. The rule includes requirements for use of a crossbow special use permit. This proposed rule at WAC 220-200-210 sets requirements allowing a qualifying person who is blind or visually impaired, such that the person is unable to safely operate an archery device or muzzleloader, to utilize a scope device during archery or muzzleloader season. Next slide, please. The rule as proposed for WAC 220-200-220 sets criteria by which a qualifying person with a disability will be allowed to operate their hunting device from within a motorized vehicle. This rule includes requirements for utilizing this special use permit. The proposed rule WAC 220-200-230 provides the option to utilize alternate casting gear in fly fishing only seasons or waters to a person with a disability whose permanent impairment renders the person incapable of holding and safely operating conventional fly fishing gear. This rule proposal includes requirements for utilizing this sub. Next slide, please. WAC 200-200-240, pardon me, that should be WAC 220-200-240, allows the department to consider requests for unique SUPs that are separate from the standard criteria for SUPs specified in WAC 220-200-200-230. The rule proposal includes criteria WDFW will consider in determining whether to grant unique requests not covered by the standard criteria. Director Suswin, do you have any questions or comments on the department's proposed new rules?
No, I do not. Thank you.
Absolutely. Next slide, please, Larry. Thank you, Director. Following the process prescribed for rulemaking in RCW 34.05, the department issued the CR 101 on May 3rd, 2022, stating its intent to consider rulemaking. Subsequently, the department requested the WDFW Commission to delegate rulemaking authority to Director Suswind for the SUP program. The commission voted unanimously to do so on May 13, 2022. On March 1, 2023, the department filed the CR 102, which we are presenting to you today. The proposed rulemaking was also posted on the department's rulemaking public web pages on March 1st, opening it for public comment. On March 8th, 2023, the department published a news release requesting input from the public and giving notice of today's public hearing. The public comment period closes tonight, April 10th, 2023, at 11:59 p.m. Next slide, please. Excuse me one moment. The public comments that we have received are summarized in this slide. Most of the more than 60 comments received were via the online public input system, segregated by each WAC, with three emails addressing general issues. Most comments are trending positive for all the proposed rules, with particular support for WAC 220-200-200, the new crossbow sub, and WAC 220-200-240, the new accessibility sub. There were not many clearly opposing comments comparatively, and a good amount of the input was not in the scope of the particular rule for which it was submitted in the online system. The gist of those comments were basically in pursuit of less restrictive rules around both the disability designation and sub qualifications. Next slide, please. And that concludes our presentation of the sub rulemaking package. And I appreciate the opportunity to present the information to you.
Thank you, Catherine. We will now take verbal public comment from attendees. If you would like to speak, please use the quote, raise hand, close quote feature located at the bottom of your screen. As a reminder, please keep your comments to 3 minutes or less. Everyone is currently muted. When it is your turn to speak, you will be recognized by your name or partial phone number and you will be unmuted by staff. At that time, please state your name for the record, just as if you were attending the meeting in person. Staff will be listening and considering your testimony. However, staff will not be responding today to comments or questions received during the meeting.
So it looks like Rory has his hand up. I will go ahead and unmute him.
Mute.
Yep. Hi. Go ahead.
This is Rory Calhoun, and I'm formerly an employee of the Recreation and Conservation Office, and I spent a majority of my life doing accessibility stuff, including a lot of hunting and fishing stuff for your agency. I'm the original person who wrote the original disabled hunter laws back in the mid-80s, and so I'm very familiar and have a lot of institutional knowledge on this. And I applaud you on changing some of the stuff and updating and making it nice. And sorry, I'm kind of sick right now. But I'd like to say that I had sick comments, and I'm particularly concerned about the blue placard whack and with the eligibility criteria, particularly including those that have parking privileges and license plates, because those people that have those, the criteria for that is completely different than what the original shoot from vehicle permit was allotted for. It was for people who could not get out of their vehicles to shoot. And typically a lot of those folks, like almost 8 out of 10 of them that are eligible under the parking placard disabled license plates, can get out of their vehicle to shoot. And so that was a really big deal for safety and working with enforcement over all the years. People like myself in a wheelchair, you can't get out to shoot. That's who made sense to be able to shoot from your car. But there's a lot of people in that criteria under the blue placards that was added some point in the last 4 or 5 years, against my comments when I heard they were doing that, allows for people that can stand up, walk away from their vehicles, and it throws a really complex thing for enforcement to figure out who's shooting from a car and then getting out and chasing their game or doing stuff. And a lot of those folks just don't need that type of special use permit. So I would ask you to go back and look at that criteria and pull that blanket statement for placard and disability placards and plates and look at the exact criteria and see what it meets for the intended people that actually need an accommodation. Those folks don't need an accommodation to shoot from a vehicle. Only certain people that can't get out of their vehicle and safely shoot from it or step out at all. So it included most people that use wheelchairs, a lot of people with amputees and other walking difficulties, but a lot of those folks that can still walk 200 feet when they get out of their car, qualify for a license plate, they don't need to shoot from their car. So I also had some questions for you that I put in my comments about the definition of equivalent license for shellfish harvesters. And I wanted to know if you could explain what you meant by that. I think you meant they would have a shellfish license, but you have shellfish 1 day, 3 day, and the licenses that they buy are not the same as when you can get a discounted fishing license. So when you say it in technology, in the technical sense of being equivalent, those aren't equivalent licenses because I get a different reduced fee license, but my partner who might be harvesting clams for might have a full price license, or they may have a 3 day shellfish license. So I'm wondering if you have some conflicts there. I'm just not sure what you meant by that. So I think I'll just close with that and let you respond to that. Thank you.
So Catherine, I don't know if you want to respond or not. Typically at these hearings, we don't respond to questions. However, I do think that we want to make sure that Mr. Calhoun gets a response, if not at this hearing.
I will make sure that he receives a response.
Thank you.
So I think that's all I see for attendees that are not WDFW staff.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Chris. So at this time, I wanted to thank those of you who provided your testimony today and to all of those who have submitted written comments to us during the comment period. We expect to receive a decision from the director in the coming days. That meeting will not be recorded, but the decision will be posted online and announced in an upcoming WDFW communications news release. Thank you again to everyone who participated. This concludes today's hearing.